Jason, where is it?
Are we on yet?
Yeah.
Are we?
Thanks for telling us. I can't see anything.
I can't either. Are we there yet, Jason?
I think so.
Do you see it?
All right, let's do this.
So, for those of you who missed yesterday, what you missed is a bunch of Movidia Technology Group and Max Slider Brothers Customs people standing in our parking lot, looking up at the sun, trying to see that brilliant eclipse, and now none of us are able to see today. So I thought maybe these glasses were for after the eclipse to help us. I'm blind as a bat, Jason.
I took mine off because my eyes still hurt from yesterday. I think I got a sunburn on my eyes. Seriously, it hurts. I can't work on my computer today.
That joke didn't go over as well as I would hope. I was hoping. But we're not here to talk about the eclipse. That's done and over with, right?
Yep.
What we're here talking about today is making businesses or helping businesses become successful using Facebook and using social media tools that they may or may not be using today. Sound good to you?
Yep. Let's do it.
Yeah. I've got a mint in my mouth because I had coffee, and last time Jason was making fun of my coffee breath.
Definitely smells better today.
And I probably smell like my high school English teacher, so I'm trying not to do that anymore. But nevertheless, today we're talking about the who. What kind of businesses, what types of businesses should be using Facebook as a marketing tool? Because the more we think about it and the more we talk about it, the more convicted we are that there is so much opportunity with the way Facebook has positioned themselves and the tools that they're bringing to market, that that we need to dig into that a little bit more to help our clients, to help those of you who are following us online. So that's what we're going to talk about. We've decided that we're going to create a how many part series did we decide?
I think six for now. I mean, we may change that.
Okay, so we're going to do a 6-part series where Jason literally breaks down the tools inside of Facebook. You know, Facebook's got all kinds of functionality you can use as a business to market your business, and you probably don't understand the tools. I know every time I look at it, there's something new that I can't figure out. So he's going to do a little like tutorial where he's showing his screen and he's kind of giving people a walkthrough of what things are and how they can use it. So look forward to that. To set that up, today we're going to talk about what types of businesses have or should be using Facebook as a marketing tool, to just kind of get you in the frame of mind so that you could watch this 6-part series and maybe have success with it.
Yep.
Yeah. All right. So, you know, it's arguably the most effective social media platform with really the widest array of businesses and tools to leverage. But there's all kinds of different businesses out there. You've got doctors, you've got landscaping companies, you've got plumbers, you've got Bronco builders, technology companies. And so it begs the question, who is it right for? Who is Facebook the right tool for people to take that one and talk about that a little
bit? All right. So I think the most important one is, so you can easily make a list of who it's, you know, who it works well for, but I think who it's right for is for businesses who will actually use it. That's the key. That's the bottom line. If you're going to do it, you need to do it and commit to it. You know, it may not work as effectively for every type of business, but it can definitely work for any business if you use it. You know, certain businesses may have to do a little research and a little testing and find out what works better for them. But it will take commitment if you're going to do it.
I think so. What you're talking about is a frame of mind you need to be in when you take advantage of Facebook. And the idea that anyone can use it, but you got to be committed and you got to be ready to put in the time.
Yep, and you need to do it right. I mean, you know, there's no perfect way. Just hiring somebody to randomly post, you know, a sentence or two of content every week that gets zero interaction, no likes, no comments, to your page that has 46 people to like it. Nobody sees that. That's frankly a waste of money. You're not creating engaging content. Nobody wants to know a tip of the day that sounds like a robot said it. I won't get too much into detail there, but if you're going to do it, you need to do it or not do it. You know, something like that is probably more detrimental to your business than helping.
Yeah. So it's funny because it begs the question, if, you know, what types of businesses are right for Facebook? Secondary follow-up question is, what businesses are not right for Facebook? And you kind of answered it, right? Tell them.
Well, got me on the spot there. What are your thoughts?
The people who are not going to take.
So that's basically
do it consistently, right? It's the people. You know, I think about. I get this a lot. People see what we're doing at MaxLayer and at Mavidia, and they ask, you know, how did you guys are having so much success? How's that happening? And you've heard us talk about it before. It's just consistency, right?
You're
consistency
doing it all and focus. The time.
We're doing it consistently. People, users, those following us can count on the fact they're going to see new, fresh content later on today, and then tomorrow, and then the next day. And so they tune into that. They plug into that. And so the people that if you're not gonna do it consistently, the types of businesses who should not use Facebook are those who don't have the time or lack the commitment or lack the feeling that there's value there. Stay away from it. Don't post once a week and expect magical things to happen, right?
Right, that's exactly it. I mean, you have to pay attention to what your followers like. You know, if they never interact with certain types of posts, maybe you shouldn't be doing those types of posts. Or maybe it's the wrong time. There's a lot of different factors. I mean, we've talked about some of those in the past, but you need to pay attention to your audience, give them more of what they want.
Yeah, I think about I had this question once. Someone, literally they had 200,000 plus followers to their Facebook page. It was a pretty sizable business. And they create a very well-known product, and we'll keep them anonymous, but a very well-known product that if I said it, you guys would be like, oh, really? Couple hundred thousand followers on Facebook and they get zero engagement.
Yep.
Like no one comments, no one likes, no one shares. And so it's like, what are you doing? And so I scrolled through their feed and I saw that it was just 10% off after 10% off after 15% off after 10% off. It was all the same thing. It was just a different product each time.
Yep.
So they were very one-dimensional. It was just promotion, 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 promotion. So why would I interact with that as a user, as a consumer, if I'm just going there to see what today's deal is?
Yep, that's a great, great example because, you know, so we've got a number of different clients. I don't help all of our clients with Facebook, but I still kind of watch and see what they do. You know, something I've seen in the past is, so e-commerce, obviously lots of competition, but women's clothing. Super competitive. And you know, one Facebook page I'm thinking of, it was a nice page. They post great pictures. They've had thousands and thousands and thousands of followers, but their posts did not get much engagement. You know, and I think 95% of their posts were their latest top or their latest, you know, whatever. And while the, you know, the images were good, you know, they obviously, you know, have their own, you know, girls who model this stuff.
Professional photographer.
Yeah, it wasn't that.
Well produced.
It was the same content over and over. And they would maybe get two or three likes out of tens of thousands of followers. You know, something's wrong there. You know, while they might be seeing it, they're blind to it.
Yeah.
Because not as many people are commenting or liking, their viewership is going down, the reach. It's not even getting shown to the tens of thousands of people because they're not giving that engaging content. So the Facebook algorithm is hiding your stuff in the first place.
Yeah,
so you have to commit to it and you have to work constantly on creating content that gets engagement.
Right. It can't all be a sales pitch. It can't all be all about the owner and their family, right? It can't be all about one single thing. It's got to be very diverse, and you've got to find the right mix for your audience. And we talked about paying attention to statistics and all the data that Facebook shows you. I know you'll go through that when you in this upcoming series that you're going to put on, Jason. But don't be one-dimensional, right? So think about different ways you can showcase the business and the different story you can tell. People connect to other people.
That's right.
And so show people. So there are all kinds of things that you can do that we'll talk about here in the future. But, you know, as you're getting started, I'm really excited about this upcoming series that you're going to put on, because I think we're talking a lot about concepts and about strategy, but we may not necessarily be doing a good job showing people exactly how they can do some things.
Right.
And so we decided after last week's session, we sat back and thought, what value can we bring to people? And it seems like you get really fired up when we talk about specific pieces of functionality, right? So Jason's going to break that down. And so starting next Tuesday at 10:30 a.m., we're going to start the first segment in that series where you're going to break down the tools for Facebook. So can you give them a little glimpse of the types of things they're going to see in this series?
Sure. So obviously I could talk on and on and on about any part of Facebook, and it's going to be very difficult for me to try to, you know, rein each of these little sections into a somewhat short video. You know, I'm going to do a walkthrough. I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to walk you through, you know, what we're talking about or what I'm talking about. I'm going to do better than, you know, just show a piece of paper and try to get into the camera. You're going to see my screen. So you can follow along. You can, you know, it's Facebook Live, but it's obviously there forever. You know, you can go to your Facebook page and walk through and make sure that you're capitalizing on these things I'm talking about. I'm going to start out more simple, but super important things that you need. You know, you got to lay that foundation.
Foundation.
It's got to be strong.
Yeah.
If you're skipping over any one of these, you're minimizing your overall effectiveness. So let's get these straight. Again, it's going to be somewhat basic, but, you know, even if you've been doing this for a while, it's important to maybe listen in and pay attention, because, you know, things change on a regular basis. They always add features in. Maybe it wasn't there when you first set it up. So pay attention. As always, have questions, you know, shoot them to us. I know I'm going to be skipping over some detail. There's just not enough time. You know, nobody wants to sit and watch 2 hours over every little module.
I do. I would.
You don't have the time.
You know what? I would make the time, because I've seen the value of doing some of these.
And it is important. So I'm going to do my best. I've got a very technical mind, so I try very hard to try to, you know, to do, you know, to cover it in a way that would appeal to people who don't already know this. So I might need your help. You know, please step in and comment and say, hey, man, these videos are great, but you're blankety blank. You know, give me feedback. I want it. So then maybe that video too, I can implement some of those ideas. So try to slow me down. I've got it up here, but I may not always be the best teacher in expressing. So that's why, you know, Eric does a great job of pulling stuff out of me. So I'm going to need your help with this. So next Tuesday, you know, make sure you join in. We're going to have an awesome, you know, 6-part series. As I get feedback, you know, we may grow that. We might shorten it. Depends on what you want. You know, I'm not here to talk, you know, as you know, I don't talk a whole lot. This is probably the most I've talked today. And it's because Kim, our marketing manager that's hiding over here, makes me do these.
She keeps waving her mouse over the end of broadcast button.
She's got hard elbows.
We need to cut it short. But seriously, it's going to be very valuable content, very interactive, where you can ask questions. If you tune in live, you can literally get Jason's help, which, trust me, these resources aren't available. So take advantage of it if you can. Tune in next Tuesday at 10:30 a.m.
Yep. Pause real quick. We had a question from the audience.
Oh, did we?
I'm going to pop that up on the screen and answer it real quick.
Oh,
now
okay.
Let you continue. So Michael says, in the women's clothing example, what are ways they could share things relevant to their audience without being overly promotional? Well, that's a very good question. In their case, you know, e-commerce, women's clothing is very tricky because there is so much competition. You know, I guarantee that they like many more than one Facebook page with these clothing things. So you have to do something different. You can't just do what everybody else is doing. Be weird like this guy.
I got an idea.
Okay, what?
I got an idea. So rather than saying, hey, here's this dress and here's 10% off, what if they showed that dress on someone, a real person who's purchased it and who wears it a lot? And the caption being something to the effect of, from the female's point of view, she's gotten this dress and she's out an event or getting ready to go, and she says, I feel so confident and I feel beautiful in this dress. I feel important, or I feel like I will get noticed. I feel, you know, how it makes that person feel. How much more compelling would that, I mean, you know, if I'm a guy, and if this sounds really weird, but if I saw someone saying that about a piece of clothing, I go, oh man, I want to feel like that too. I want to buy that too. Think about how different that is than a typical, this thing is 10% off. Buy it now. Look at it on, look how great it looks on this model who we paid to be here because she's very attractive or whatever. And she has the right figure, right? Showing on a common person, and that person saying, I feel confident and excited because I'm going out tonight and I'm going to, you know, with the person I love, and I feel beautiful. Right?
That's right. You know, you could have, you know, user submitted content, you know, tag yourself.
Oh man.
Submit a picture of you going out in your new dress or your new top, or even if it's just hanging out, whatever. User generated content, you know, message us the pic. Let us know a little bit about the setting. You can tag, you know, do we have permission to tag yourself or not? But that is going to get some attention. And then all of your friends are going to interact with it because they're going to see you on it, or the person who was wearing the item. Things like that, you know, connect with people. Don't make it all about the sale and getting your next item in front of them. While all that is good, you know, mix it up. You know, I've looked at some of these companies' Instagram pages, and the Instagram images that get the most interaction, it might be a quote that it has to do with maybe their demographic that they all can relate to, you know, so just mix it up.
Yeah, be relevant. And with that said, Kim has now got up and left the room because she's frustrated with us and how long we go. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure you tune in next Tuesday to see Jason start this process of breaking down Facebook for you as the business owner so you can have real tools and knowledge to help you get started. Jason and Eric, Movidia Technology Group, God bless. Have a great day.
See you guys.